This is Ruthie from Syndicated News, and we're going to be interviewing Mayor Jim Tulley from Titusville, Florida. Mayor Tulley, are you with us?
I'm right here. Good to be with you, Ruthie.
Welcome to Syndicated News, DiTucci. We so appreciate you joining us and giving us an idea of what's going on in town. Well, let's start with the Greater Titusville Renaissance.
Well, Greater Titusville Renaissance was an idea that started about a year and a half ago when Commissioner Robin Fisher and I were sitting in the back of a golf cart in the rain on Martin Luther King Day, waiting to participate in that parade. And we got to talking about the TV show Extreme Makeover and how he was envisioning redoing Titusville and how Titusville needs to have a makeover of sorts. And we both agreed that the city needed to be cleaned up, the city needed to have a new face, and the city needed to be more appealing to both the residents and visitors and businesses that might want to come here. And the only discussion, we both agreed on that virtually immediately, and then, of course, the discussion led to what should we call this thing. And I proposed that maybe Extreme Makeover was a little bit too severe because, as you know, in that TV show, they basically knock everything down and start over. And I said to the commissioner, you know, we've got a lot of good stuff here in Titusville, and I don't think we want to knock everything down and start over. But the city needs a certain renaissance, if you would. And that wasn't really my term. The city manager, Mark Ryan, came up with the term renaissance. And it seemed to fit because we recognized quite quickly that it wasn't just about the physical turnaround of the city, making it look nicer. It also had to be about how we think about ourselves. And that was just as important. So Renaissance fit because it was about what we look like and how we think. And so we decided to call it Greater Titusville Renaissance because in order for the commissioner to be part of it, it had to be about more than just the city of Titusville. It had to be about his whole district, about the whole North Brevard area, of which Titusville is right in the center. So Greater Titusville Renaissance was born, and we've got some great help from the citizens. It's become a grassroots effort. When we have our annual meetings, we typically have 100-plus volunteers there, and we've broken it down into three main projects. And that is bringing business into the greater Titusville area, cleaning up our corridors, and doing something about arts and culture. I like to call it the three C's, commerce, culture, and corridors. And so that's what we're doing, and I think we're making progress. Like everything else, Rome wasn't built in a day. It'll take some time, but I think many of our citizens are on board, and I think we'll get it done. And I think if you come back to Titusville in 5 years, you probably won't recognize the changes that will have taken effect because of, not just because of Greater Titusville Renaissance, there are other things going on, but Greater Titusville Renaissance will be a big part of it.
In that sense, I'd like to mention arts, culture, and Stonefire. Would you give us some information on that? Because I remember you knew quite a bit about those projects.
Well, Stonefire sort of sprung up on its own. The commissioner has helped it in that he negotiated a deal with the property owner at Miracle City Mall to allow Stonefire to have use of that old Firestone facility, basically rent-free. All they have to do is pay for the utilities. And Maxine Trainer has been remarkable in bringing together artists, especially young artists. She's done a great job with the student artists there at Stonefire. So much so that I recognized that they could be helpful to our community and tried to join them together into the Renaissance effort. And as I mentioned earlier, one of the things we're trying to do is clean up our corridors, and that involves litter control. So the students have been incredible in producing a set of really creative non-litter signs, a couple of which we've already planted in the Harrison Street Park across the street from Stonefire, and we're going to start putting them up in other parks around the community to try and encourage our citizens not to drop litter to begin with. We've had a lot of pickup days, and every year we have a trash bash, and I would tell you after 4 years of doing this as the mayor, and I go out from time to time and pick up trash myself because I want to lead by example, I'm really tired of picking it up. I'd much rather solve the problem at the root cause. So the student artists at Stonefire have just been remarkable in some of the art they've produced that we've turned into non-litter signs. And they've been a huge factor, I think, and will continue to be a factor as we start to spread these signs around the community, first in the parks, and then as we figure out how to do it along the highways and byways of our community.
And we wanted to mention also the Mayor's Cup Challenge. Give us the background on that. We don't know what that's about.
Well, the Mayor's Cup Challenge came from Mayor Bloomberg in New York, and there is apparently a prize for really creative things that are going on in cities. And the first prize is $5 million, and then the next four would be $1 million each. So there's quite a bit of money on the table from this Bloomberg Foundation, I think, that we are competing for. And we're competing. The proposal we submitted had to do a lot with Greater Titusville Renaissance, because we think Renaissance is a creative approach to turning a city around in various dimensions that I've already mentioned. And we're hopeful that that creative thinking and Renaissance and the citizen participation and what we're doing will be recognized, and we might be in line for one of those awards, which would be a great help to Renaissance, because a lot of the things that Renaissance wants to do require some funding. And as you know, we live in very challenging times these days. Both the city and the county budgets are stretched about as thin as they can be stretched. So to have a new source of revenue, a new source of funding for some of the Renaissance things would be just huge for what we're trying to do.
And maybe you can throw some light on changing the community mindset. How are you going to do that?
Well, I think it starts with individuals. It starts with taking personal responsibility, every one of us as individuals, for number one, keeping our community clean, making our community cleaner, nicer looking, and having that mindset that we take a positive approach to what we're trying to do here in Titusville. I get tired sometimes of the naysayers and the frequent bloggers that only see the negative. And so we're trying to turn that mindset around, that the only way you can improve a place is to have a positive attitude about it and recognize that there are warts and there are things that have to be improved, but go to work to start improving them rather than just point fingers at all the things that are wrong. You know, it's been said many times, it's better to light a candle and curse the darkness, right? And we have to create that kind of mindset in Titusville. And there are a lot of people that are already there. Most of the people that are volunteering for Renaissance already have that mindset. We just have to make it spread throughout the community and sort of turn off these naysayers that only want to look towards the negative, that display Titusville in a more positive light.
They could look at the comeback and look at all the good things that are happening in this community.
Well, that's great news. And since the last time you and I spoke, you may be aware or not that Miracle City Mall has actually come under contract. We've got it, we think, sold again this time, and the new developer has 6 months to do a feasibility study and his due diligence to make sure that he can get all the tenants that he expects to be able to bring into that mall. And I would tell you, I've seen a sketch of the site plan for what he's anticipating building, and it's a very creative plan. I really look forward to this happening, so that's good news for Titusville also. And that will fit right into this whole Renaissance mindset, that not only are we going to redevelop, but we're going to redevelop things that are unique to Titusville. As you know, the Titusville city motto is Gateway to Nature and Space, and we see ourselves as a very unique community here on the east coast of Florida, unlike most other places that people might choose to visit. And people will choose to come here because of the unique nature of this community.
And I remember we also interviewed Dr. Al Kohler, because he was heading a company that certifies all the technicians that work at NASA and on the spacecraft. And it was the only body in the United States and Canada that actually certifies those very important technical support folk.
That's right. And so space will always be an important part of this community. And, you know, it's funny, I hear people say, visitors sometimes will say, well, how come Kennedy Space Center is closed? And they have that false impression simply because the space shuttle program has ended. But space is still alive and well here at Kennedy Space Center, and it will always be a huge part of what goes on here in Titusville. And as you also may be aware, NASA is getting ready to roll Space Shuttle Atlantis from its preparation facility out there at KSC over to the Kennedy Visitor Center there that Delaware North operates to put it on display so that visitors will be able to come in and actually see the Space Shuttle Atlantis. So we're looking forward to that rollover. It's going to be a great day for Titusville and for the North Brevard area in general.
And I wanted to mention Sand Point Plaza. What's going on with them?
Well, that's a little bit further out. That's 14 acres up on the north side of Titusville, right near the intersection of US 1 and Garden Street. And it's right on the gateway out to the National Wildlife Refuge and the National Seashore. And I envision a hotel conference center there on that site. Now, that's going to take a lot of work because we know that we probably at this point don't have the numbers yet to support the room nights necessary, but we're trying to locate a visionary developer who can recognize the potential of that so that as we develop East Coast Passenger Rail and we develop our railroad station, and of course we've got the Birding Festival and we've got the Turtle Festival and we've got two bicycle trails that intersect right at that same intersection. There's so much that goes on within just a mile or two of that intersection that we think it would be a great place for a hotel conference center. I've talked to the CEO of Parish Medical Center, George Mkhitaryan, and he'd like to be able to put on medical conferences there. We've got the two wildlife festivals, birding and turtles. We've got the redfish tournaments that occur in the fall and the spring. So there's just a huge amount of things that focus on that part of town, and that highlights the gateway to nature part of Titusville, and that's basically as close to nature as you can get and still be within the city limits of Titusville. So that's a long-range goal, but it certainly fits in with our thinking of what Titusville will become within the next 5 years.
Thank you.
Well, Ruthie, it's great talking to you. This is Jim Tulley, mayor of Titusville, Florida, and it's great to welcome you and John McEuen, CEO of syndicatednews.net, and it's great to have you as a licensed company right here in our own town of Titusville, Florida. Thank you so much.